हेलो 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 एक नंबर हेलो हेलो
in this workshop. Now I invite Dr. Devendra Sarit sir to give Dr. Alex Wong, please give a bouquet to our chairperson, Dr. Suresh Goyal. Dr. Anuradha, please hand over a bouquet to Dr. Anju Gambhir. Dr. Asif, please hand over a bouquet to Dr. Sameer Gupta. Dr. Ashish Talpati, please hand over a bouquet to Dr. Amit. And I am going to talk with Dr. So before I invite Dr. Ajay Gambhir for giving me a brief overview of this workshop, because many of our delegates who are coming from Jaipur are stuck in the way because their train got late. So even the basic ventilation techniques need to be refined. We need to learn more and more about the basic techniques also. So this 2 days workshop will have many sessions. In the pre-lunch session we will have lectures, and in the
respect to Dr. Goyal, Dr. Sameer, Abhishek, Amit, Dr. Anju, Dr. Sunil and other faculty of the department. Now, this is a preface, and I will be very casual and open that we had, it is not going to be your best workshop, but we are trying to make a template, and your feedback will be very, very important, because there are different spectrum of people who will be coming here, and though this has been done on a very short notice, we will try to improve this as it comes to. Dr. Poswal has made the job very easier for us to make that this is advances in ventilation. Advances in ventilation, everyone was talking in a different way. Now we have to go on the country specific need. Now when you talk about the country specific need, I need to say that what are the technology is the same now. The transfer of technology is in the next day in India, but how we use the technology is very, very important. Now technology cannot be used. Hospital is sending almost 10 persons per year for the fellowship program, and anyone of you who is interested can contact Dr. Amit or me directly. They are getting the interviews program. Even the RCPC people have contacted us, and lot of other hospitals, 3 or 4 more hospitals have contacted us for the persons who want to work in the VICU and NICU. So this is a success story. Now this has happened because of the handholding. And we say that our system is different, and that is why for the youngsters it will be opening them how to work with the system. So in a team, doctor and nurses are very, very important. So you have to take your nurses, you have to take your technicians, you have to take your infection control lacking. What was lacking was only one or two institute were able to do given training. In such a large country like India, 26 million babies are born. Almost 50% are low birth weight baby or premature baby. The need for the care is immense. So what we wanted was the quality programs, the quality checks. So I started with the quality program that is known as the X. When there were death in Bengal, 300 deaths in Bengal in just 1 week, and 300 deaths in Srinagar, when our team was sent, the system was not, they had ventilator. 20 crore was given by Ganguly, they had lot of ventilators, but still the people were dying. What was the issue? Issue was many. So number one is the spacing. So you need not bother. Technology is so good that I use the same SIM card as the Prime Minister of India is using. So from, I always say, from Mangalpuri to Manchester, from slum of India to Manchester, we
ventilation. I can put my any circuit, I can break my any circuit, and I was even writing outside without taking any new instruments. When the dragon, techniques dragon, the people are not buying it. But whole load will come on one day.
I want to tell you, but we want to also listen from you and see particular experience. So we'll have their brief introduction from which place they are. And any question, sir?
I am Dr. Mohammed Asif, Assistant Professor in the Department of Genetics and Joint Organizing Secretary for Rajiv Bhattacharya.
I am Dr. Arvind Suman, Professor of Pediatrics in this department.
I am Dr. Degeni Sari, Senior Professor in the Department of Pediatrics.
Rajasthan, I see people here from Gujarat, Rajasthan and Maharashtra. Whether this 108 is working very nicely or not. What is the timeline we have done the auditing that within half an hour it should be available?
IAP family. So now I invite the chairperson of this workshop who brought this department from a very, very primitive stage up to this well-equipped status which you all know and which you will see in the coming few days, that our department is well-equipped. We have some 25 to 30 ventilators of high quality, and we have monitors in each and every facility which an intensive care.
Good morning, everybody. At the outset, I am trying to thank Dr. Ali Gandhi, President elect. We all know his missionary zeal and his zeal to do better for the neonates and children, to save them. And I know him for last 2 years. He is devoting almost all of his time towards achieving this national goal of improving the child health. Dr. Anju Bobby, Dr. Amit Gupta, and my 2 dear students of Sabis and Dr. Abhishek. I think in 1990, it is almost 24 years. And he was a bright student here and is doing a wonderful job after his graduation from this college. Dr. Sameer, and everybody knows that in the past years, when we were doing MD in 80s and 90s, we were working in a very primitive type of setup. They were even in those type of situations. But today, the things are very different. We have got almost 20-25 ventilators of high quality. And most of my residents who are going out of the college after doing MD, they were at least basic ventilation. And they are saving hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of children. Not only here. And they are saving territory also. And this will have impact on the neonatal and child supply.
They especially taken more pains for successful organization of this workshop. I wish success to this workshop.
So,
first of all, sincere greetings and thanks to Professor Goel Saab for inviting to this excellent program. And thanks to Dr. Gambhir and Dr. Gupta for hosting this workshop. Now, I won't take a lot of time because I know you all want to hear the real world. But what Dr. Goel just mentioned, and the whole credit goes in a single room where you would put the baby
babies who come on a couch, and we put as many babies as can come on a couch. If a baby needs a ventilator, put a tube down and we hand ventilate overnight if the needs are appropriate. Having 25 ventilators and 140 cars is a great work. It doesn't come for free. It means a lot of work, and we can discuss, participate, ask questions and clear your doubts, maybe during the sessions or after the sessions. So it would be a nice thing for all of us, not only to give away.
I met Dr. Gambhir, I think 4 years ago, or 5 years ago, at Hyderabad. And we've been working together since. And we've set up a fellowship which is working quite well. And I think there's been a program of doing a lot of workshops as well up and down the country. So that's very good. But I was quite impressed. I was saying to Dr. Sameer Gupta that I'm quite impressed. 25 ventilators, that's quite something. In Oxford, we don't have 25 ventilators. We've got far less than that. So, so I'll start with the basics. Now, I know that this is an advanced ventilation workshop. But even if it's advanced, I think if you start with the basic whatever and go back on to the basics. And so I'll take some time, and these my has gone to the peripheral tissues. As the oxygen tension falls in the peripheral tissues, it releases oxygen very quickly. Okay. So that's very important. So these are the basic mechanisms of carbon dioxide and oxygen pickup and release. I thought this would be a good point to understand the basics of oxygenation and carbon dioxide. I'll come to another concept, which is the ventilation perfusion imbalance. And I think that
I don't MP that this thing often have ABT, but they don't have ventilators. So the issues in India are very, very different, but definitely ABT.
There is another section of which babies to ventilate.
Which babies?
So let's briefly touch upon that which babies should be ventilated. And I really like one of the comments which we all practice. Rule number one, do something which you are good at. Don't do something.
If I'm honest with you, the high frequency of our unit we do not use as a primary mode. As I said, in RDS, for RDS. So we are looking at what is the appropriate anthropology for the babies. So that is the only reason why we are using it. BG is used for the trial, but not for us.
You are using complementation just to prevent further trauma and safety. That is your primary modality. I think so. I hope.
No, the important
part, like we are saying, that we are saddle body and we are preventing bio trauma.
The sign is filling up very early, maintaining the pressure like a square very often. Okay? So next step advantage is that the lower pressure, because the pressure is not the same, the flow is maintained, so the injury to the elbow should be less. Correctly. If you target, what is happening, we are using the PTB mode and setting the volume that you deliver. We want to deliver 4 minutes or 5 minutes or
gas flow delivered to achieve a particular target pressure, and eventually what happens is that if the lung is very compliant, and soft and flexible, for the same pressure it is likely to over-distend the lungs. Is that for the same, if you're very compliant lung. And I think lungs are very compliant soon after you do it supply. And the chances of this change is very quickly. Whereas in volume cycle ventilation, you've got the tidal volume which is set.
And that is an appropriate way of weaning the babies on SIMV. So just a word about pressure support, it's an excellent mode. And we have done some trials on the pressure support which I am going to share with you day after tomorrow. Coming to the is above the glottis, above the vocal cords, is called non-invasive. Once it crosses the glottis, it becomes invasive. So anything that you are using, up to using a laryngeal mask airway in large baby, will be termed as non-invasive. Okay? This is very interesting because it was mentioned about the number of days, how it changes on the ventilation. This is the data from our northern region in UK. And if you see the data which are green, CPAP started becoming available as a flow driver in UK. Because the CPAP became available, it started getting used more. So you see what happened. In 1991, the duration of ventilation, a median duration was 8 days. And it reduced to a median duration of 5 days in 2001.
ये सब डाकन कॉल
सर बुक की रेडी
हां मैं
Surfactant, they are just 10%, but they are very important for the metabolism function or integrity of surfactant molecules. A slide about the production and metabolism of surfactant. As I said, type 2 monocytes produce surfactant, and this phospholipid is produced by drug endoplasm in the reticulum, and then it is stored in the lamellar body along with these surfactant proteins. Then these lamellar bodies secrete or merge with the surface of plasma membrane type 2 monocytes and release surfactant into the alveolar inner surface. Here it forms the tubular myelin, which it thus looks like this. This is a lipid monolayer, and this lipid monolayer becomes the lipid bilayer, and head to tail alignment is there. And then it, see, this is the hydrophilic end of surfactant and this is the hydrophobic end. And how it actually looks like when it lies there, you know, is like this. Now the job, as I said, the job of surfactant is to reduce the surface.
So, this is an infant who then is admitted to the new retina, and what we notice is that the saturations are persistently low. Saturations don't go beyond 85%. After facial oxygen, we give over 98% temporarily.
Participant of NR.
that I could not shake even one. Everybody was stuck to the NRP workshop only. We will do NRP workshop only. So this is the popularity of NRP workshop, for which I give compliments to all the faculty and especially Dr. Vikas Goyal. So I hope the facilities you expected we have been able to provide. Now I invite Dr. Vikas Goyal to conduct a scientific program. Thank you so much.
75% cases, it was reviewed, when the NRP was reviewed, it was found that in 75% of cases, the mortality or the injury to the child was because of, or there was a part of the deficiency or self on enhancement of skills. Okay? And how to develop a good teamwork and how to better the communication. We are already late by 1 hour. Usually we do not allow this type of things, but somehow it has been done. We have messaged everybody that the workshop would start at 9. But since we are late, so we will try to accommodate all the things that we want to do. Now, you all should pay attention, your full attention.
And only less than 1% required for this complex of intensive. This
suppression, which involves chest compression. अब ये है कि फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ये आपको पता होना चाहिए हर हर रिवॉर्ड जब लगा होता है तो अपने कितने लोग चाहिए होते हैं दो चाहिए सब बढ़िया चल रहा है सड़क
एंड इसमें आप कितना जब आपको चेक करना है आप क्या क्या चेक करेंगे
तो फिर मेरे पास छः आने चाहिए 39 है
appreciate
एफिशिएंट नहीं करोगे तो नहीं होगा। हाँ आप बता दें।
We should also care about the supervision and also care about the discipline in the institute and all things which create better outcomes. Like if we अगर हम ध्यान रखते हैं इस चीज़ का कि कहाँ अगर मीटिंग करनी है कहाँ नहीं करनी है और लाइट्स का साउंड का इन सब चीज़ों का भी बहुत।
So we talk about infection control. Infection control is must. Without that, there is no use of running the intensive care. That's very, very important. It is the integrative. When you say advances, it is advances not in the knowledge, but advances in our attitude and the practices also. If our practices don't change, and very well said, quality is issues. So, do not do harm. Dr. Samir told, if you don't know, do not do any harm. So quality issue. If you take this key of message, practically you can come to me, come to someone, if you work for 10-15 days, you will feel more confident. So these are very, very important issues and this will help us to take care. Now, if we want to do this, then we will do this. What will be good, what will be good, what will be good, what will be good. Yeah.
And we were doing fumigation very frequently, but it was very difficult to control the infection. What we did fumigation and completely shut down ourselves, closed the roof from the outside, and we did it for 7 to 10 days. If you do this, the infection will be dramatically controlled, even if it is a very refractory candidiasis. So this I want to add, you just don't do one chamber and another chamber, another chamber, we have to shut down.
What teaches one first part in the infection control is spacing. We don't get this spacing guided by the LHM Government of India on 50 square feet or 100 square feet, depending upon the things. The second thing is how do you clean it? There has to be standard procedure. The policy has to be written. Hand washing policy has to be clear. No excuses for anyone. हमारे जाते हैं, हमारे बॉस भी जाते हैं, घड़ी लटकी हुई है, नहीं है। अगर पेशेंट को टच करना है तो सब घड़ी उधर जाएगी, सब हमारी मुंदरियाँ उधर जाएंगी, सब चेंज उधर जाएंगी। So infection prevention करना है। Now that is a thing. What is the infection? Okay, stations पे क्या था? Stations पे what did you learn on the stations? Anything new or where you are fascinated or that stimulated you? You know? Okay. HF को देखना मतलब I see that is good you know.
Balloon but not being able to see. Whether the balloon is blown too much, too little, or appropriately. And this is not one balloon, it's like a box of balloons covered in a box which we cannot see. So the graphics are giving us the response of the lungs. And so we can see, just like we see ECG and know quite a bit about the heart. You see the graphics and you know quite a bit about what is happening at that moment with the lungs. And you can fine-tune your ventilation very nicely. Now the three important things the ventilator, any tidal volume when you give a breath, the three parameters are pressure, volume and flow, which are interdependent, and in the usual modes we use, the ventilator can control either pressure or either flow, and in dual modes it can control both. So one becomes an independent variable, where it's in pressure control, that is independent, controlled by ventilator. But the volume and flow delivered will vary according to the patient's lungs. Reverse is true when you're using volume control, which we use less commonly in pediatrics, but still we do use. That the volume is the control factor, so the changes in pressure will tell us how the lung, how the lung is behaving and how good or bad it is. Looking at the lungs only by the lung elastic forces of compliance of the lung. So the plateau pressure will actually reflect the true compliance of the lung, whereas peak will reflect compliance plus resistance. Okay. So if you see, this is the resistance pressure. So whenever resistance increases, like asthma or bronchospasm, you will find that this portion, the peak is increasing, but the plateau remains the same. Whereas in conditions like atelectasis, ARDS, pulmonary edema, the compliance is affected. So the whole thing will increase, but this part, the compliance part, is the one which will increase more. The distance will remain the same. what this is showing, that increase airway resistance, you'll find the peak pressure goes up, but the plateau pressure has not gone up much. You have decreased compliance due to arterial cases, edema. You find the peak pressure.
And there is sudden deterioration and it could go on to a pneumothorax,
which is why I am here.
Listening so patiently so far, you have to bear with me for the next half an hour or so. The topic I wanted to talk about, what's on your list, is about long-term ventilation. And I suspect it's not very relevant to the audience at the moment, but I can tell you that it will become relevant if you look after more and more data movements as your time goes past, and you know, that's going to be a phenomenon.
Curious, you keep learning, and
device Kalila
और उसको प्रैक्टिस में लाइएगा। यदि रिवाइज नहीं करेंगे तो विद इन अ वीक यू विल फॉरगेट 50% एंड इफ यू डोंट प्रैक्टिस यू फॉरगेट रिमेनिंग 50% इन अनदर 3%। तो रिवाइज एंड प्रैक्टिस एंड यहाँ के जो स्टूडेंट्स और फैकल्टी मेम्बर्स वेंटिलेशन कर रहे हैं दे शुड ट्राई टू इम्प्रूव अपॉन द प्रैक्टिसेस विच वी आर डूइंग।
This conference are Dr. Abhishek Bansal and Dr. Ajay Gambhir. So I request all of you to please give specific hand. During 25 years of my presence in the pediatrics, right from my residency till this post as a professor, I honestly say that I have never attended such a high quality workshop. I have attended workshop in the international conferences, in the national conferences, in the state conferences, but this quality is so much interested to teach and to impart the knowledge, especially the practical knowledge, practical tidbits, how minor changes in the settings of ventilation can bring good results, can improve the oxygenation of the daily. So, the international faculty, Dr. Sameer Gupta, Dr. Amit Gupta, and our national top leaders in the neonatology, Dr. Ajay, his better half, Dr. Anju, and Dr. Abhishek, really deserve a big applause together.
Filters, they will normally That contains a filter also. दूसरे हमको यूज करते हैं TPN वगैरह के साथ, अगर हम जब TPN वगैरह दे रहे हैं तो उसके साथ हमको फिल्टर यूज करते हैं। हाँ जी नहीं नहीं मैं कह रहा हूँ TPN वाले फिल्टर अलग हैं बिकॉज उसमें तो हमारा फैट वो जा रहा है, वो वाले फिल्टर अलग है, लेकिन ये वाले फिल्टर अलग है, इसके साथ फिल्टर वाला भी आता है। But as the technique is changing, we can see what is our cost effective for us. It is not must that we should use this filter. और umbilical line को यूज करना कितनी देर से यूज करता है, बिकॉज लॉन्ग लाइन डालना बड़ा मुश्किल है। यहाँ पे भी मैंने देखा लॉन्ग लाइन बहुत कम डाली हुई है, लॉन्ग लाइन डालना आसान भी नहीं होता, लॉन्ग लाइन से इन्फेक्शन के बाद बढ़ जाता है। सो इट्स नॉट मस्ट दैट यू मस्ट यूज लॉन्ग लाइन। इंडियन सर्कमस्टांसेस में इफ यू पुट अ अम्बिलिकल लाइन एंड इफ यू कैन यूज अम्बिलिकल लाइन फ्रॉम 3 to 7 days एंड देन रिमूव द अम्बिलिकल लाइन एंड इन मीन टाइम स्टार्ट विद द EVM एंड विद द टेलीफोन दैट इज गुड एनफ।
10 days
देखो वो तो एक्सटेंशन होता रहेगा, बट वी वॉन्ट की एज सुन एज पॉसिबल वी शुड बी आउट बिकॉज दिस इज सोर्स। यस 10 days तक जा सकते हैं, बट उसके लिए वी वॉन्ट की यू शुड यूज मल्टी ल्यूमन सो दैट वी कैन यूज इट फॉर अदर पर्पज ऑल्सो। हम एक्सटेंशन लगा सकते हैं या मल्टी ल्यूमन भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं बिकॉज सिग्नल ला कर कई बार हम लोग ना उसके यूज़ भी कर सकते हैं, कुछ ड्रग देने के लिए, कुछ फीड देने के लिए, यू कैन यूज दिस फॉर मेजरिंग नॉट ओनली द आईवी फ्लूइड्स, यू कैन यूज इट फॉर सच। मल्टी ल्यूमन वाला यूज़ कर लो या फिर हमने अटैचमेंट लगा के RCP लगा दो उसके साथ, तो दैट विल हेल्प यू। और एक एक को भी मार्क कर दो, आप कलर कोडिंग भी कर सकते हो, मार्क कर सकते हो कि आप दैट दिस ड्रग हैज टू गो थ्रू सर्जरी। और वो एक अच्छी सिस्टम को लगा दो, पैरामेडिकल्स को मैंने देखा एक बार सिखा दो सीख जाते हैं, यू नो दे आर वेरी ट्रेनेबल पर्सन एंड दे आर वेरी सिंसियरली एंड उनकी हम कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग करेंगे, दे आर वेरी यूजफुल पीपल। हर डॉक्टर हर चीज नहीं कर सकते। ठीक है, ये लोग लेके आए हैं कंपनी वाले, ये लेके आए, ये
वो प्रेशर इसलिए बढ़ा रहे हैं कि सडन ओरिंग को वेट नहीं करेंगे
जो वन ऑफ द रीज़न्स
का टाइगर प्रॉब्लम है। अच्छा मॉडल सर, सो इट रिड्यूसेस द
But what I also want to tell you is that large scale trials, 28 weeks in niche, 60% recurrence rate is available without any surfactant.
Friend will ask why not to have a certificate
for it is trust level, legal issues. Legal issues jab aate hain, either trust between a doctor and a patient. If you look at data in the US, people who documents so that it has got nothing to do with the उनका मिल रहा है मेरे बच्चे का भी बता रहे हैं अब मुझे गलती होगी Parents do not sue doctors just because something has gone wrong. Generally, if your relationship with them is one of trust, and if they feel that you care,
sir, is one
पूरी कोशिश कर ली एक चीज अपने
सर्किट आप बना सकते हो इसी बड़े फैक्ट के साथ अटैच करो 40,000 रुपये फायर मिलता है